In this segment, we're going to take an example of a polynomial regression model. So we have a polynomial regression model. I'm going to take an example to see that how do we do polynomial regression to data. So let's suppose somebody gives us alpha versus temperature data. So somebody is giving us alpha and temperature. So alpha is a thermal expansion coefficient. The units of that are, let's suppose, micro inch per degree Fahrenheit. And the temperature, let's suppose, is given in degrees Fahrenheit. So somebody is giving us alpha versus temperature data and would like us to regress it to, let's suppose, a second order polynomial. So let me write down the data first. So this is of a typical steel. The temperatures are given at 80, 40, minus 40, minus 120, minus 200, and minus 280. So we're given six different temperatures, and we are given six different values of alpha. And as you can see that as you decrease the temperature, so does the value of alpha, which means that you get less expansion per unit temperature as you go through cryogenic temperatures. So here we have alpha versus temperature data given to us. And let's suppose somebody tells us, hey, go ahead and regress it to a second order polynomial. So I want you to regress the alpha versus temperature data which is given to you to second order polynomial, which means that you have to find out what these three coefficients are, A0, A1, and A2. So if you are able to find out what these three constants of the second order polynomial model are, you have been able to do your regression. So based on that, let's suppose somebody then at the end says that, hey, okay, once you find out what the constants of this regression model are, can you give me what the value of alpha is at 70 degrees Fahrenheit? Can you predict what the value of the thermal expansion coefficient will be at 70 degrees Fahrenheit? Now, from previous segment, we already know what the formula for the polynomial regression model is. I'm going to write it down here for this particular case, for the second order polynomial case. And that looks like this. So you have these constants A0, A1, and A2 can be found out if we are able to solve these set of equations. So you have A0, A1, A2. They are the three constants of the polynomial model. And you have N times summation t sub I square. You got summation t sub I here, summation of t sub I squared here, summation of t sub I cube here, then summation of t sub I square here, summation t sub I cube here, and summation of t sub I 4 here. So those are the summations which you need, where t is the temperature. Those are the summations which you need to be able to fill in this coefficient matrix. And then the right-hand side is nothing but summation of alpha i's, summation of alpha I t sub i's, and summation of alpha I t sub I squares. All these summations go from 1 to n, where n is the number of data points. So I've not put the summations in there just so that the coefficient matrix does not look crowded. There's no other reason for me not to show those summations on all of these summations which you see in these three simultaneous linear equations. So the bottom line is to be able to fill in the coefficient matrix, to be able to fill in the right-hand side vector. And once you know what the right-hand side vector is, what the coefficient matrix is, you should be able to find out what A0, A1, A2 are, the three coefficients or the three constants of the regression model. That's all there is to it. So we already know that N is equal to 6. So that will take care of the first row, first column of this. Now, summation of T sub I, I'm going to show you some of them and other ones which you can do at home. So summation of t sub I is just adding all the t sub I values, 80, 40, minus 40, minus 120, minus 200, minus 280. The reason why you have a minus sign is because the temperatures are negative, not I'm subtracting anything. So I'm adding all the TI values, and those will now be minus 520. So that's the summation of all the TI values. So I'm going to show you one more, let's suppose. I want to find out the summation of all the TI square values, which would be simply 80 square plus 40 square plus minus 40 square plus minus 120 square plus minus 200 square plus minus 280 square. And this value here, turns out to be 1.424 times 10 to the power 5. So that's what you get by summing all the TI square values. So similarly, you can find out what the summation of TI cube is, TI to the power 4 is, because that's what you need. You need TI square. So if you look at the coefficient matrix again here, you need a summation of T sub I, summation of TI, T sub I square, T sub I cube, and T sub I 4. So I'm going to just write those down here. So you get summation of T sub I cube, that is adding all the, taking cube of all the temperatures and adding them up, and you get minus 3.117 times 10 to the power 7. The reason why you need a minus sign is because there are negative temperatures also in the data. And then summation of T sub I raised to the power 4, again, this will be a positive value because you are taking an even power of temperatures. And that turns out to be 8.000 times 10 to the power 9. So these are all the summations which you need for the coefficient matrix. Let's go and see that how we will calculate the summations which we need for the right-hand side vector. So